I'll make a shoehorn out of your shin. I'll make a lampshade of durable skin. No, don't you know that I'm always feeling able when I'm sitting home and I'm carving out your navel. I'm just a sitting here carving out your navel. When will I realize that this skin I'm in, hey, it isn't mine? And when will the kill be too much of me?
Welcome back to Buzzard on Guitar. Today's band is a superb band, a really fantastic group, who only did two albums with their original singer until he tragically passed away in 1995. I was very lucky to see Blind Melon at the Reading Festival in August of 1995, first discovering them, like everybody, I guess, through the single No Rain off their debut album. This song is a song called Skinned, and it features on, as I said, the second studio album, Soup. And it's a tongue-in-cheek kind of ditty about serial killer Ed Gein. If you don't know who Ed Gein was, easy enough to find out. You do a bit of a Googling, tippy-tappy, and you'll just kind of get the lyrics, I think, if you understand a bit about what he got up to on a daily basis. Okay, so starting off then, we're playing around two chords, G. Notice the way that I'm playing that, because we'll need to keep this position. It's pretty vital. And E7. We do alter that chord as well to a sharp 9. We had a sharp 9 as we play that. Okay, I'll play through the first part. Etc. So, as I was saying, the G's played like this. And there's two things to bear in mind here. One, you want to mute the fifth string with that finger. We don't really want the droning. We're not playing the B like a traditional G here. We're not incorporating the B, the third. So we're going to mute that fifth string. And I do really, because I want to strum really freely, I do try to mute the first string as well. Very important, because the melody wants to really stand out there. So it's really, if you can, add that little bit of a great technique there and just mute that first string. So I'm playing G. Okay. When you play the G, when you're playing just sort of the triad and you've only got the one finger, and again, just try and not... It doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't really matter too much. But really, you're wanting to kind of have a, you know, the G or the B at the top of that chord. So I'm playing G5, technically. G sus 4, G, the little run, open third, 2-1 open on the second, back to the open third. Okay, E7, first kind of half, as I said, we had a sharp 9, so I'm adding the G note here, third fret, first string. The run here is, okay, so I'm playing E to D or 2 to 0 on the 4th string. And then on the 5th string, I'm playing A, a little bit of chromaticism here, B flat into B, and to the D again. So some really key notes based around that E7 chord, root, 7th. Okay, you've got your 11th perhaps there, and then you've got that flat 5, 5, and back to the flat and 7th, the D. The second half, what I'm just doing again, sometimes when I listen to this and slowed it down, you can tend to hear, I think, a little bit, again, chromaticism. So what I'm doing there is I'm playing the, again, the D, the flat and seventh note. Sliding that up. Okay, keeping that E at the top ringing, because it's only passing, so I know there's dissonance there, but you're only passing. And it adds a nice effect. I'm back to the E7, but again, I'm catching it from the top, so I'm hitting the E. And then into the run. So that's your first part. It draws to an end. G. You can play a G whichever way there, as long as you've got the key harmony. Stop the G chord dead. If you watched my Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting video, you'll see these shapes a bit, or at the beginning, I think, of that one. What I'm doing is I'm half barring on the 5th fret, so that's the 4th, 3rd and 2nd string. I'm adding 7th fret on the 3rd string, and I'm adding 6th fret on the 2nd string. This implies a G7 chord. It's kind of 1-5. And at the top, then I just play the standard G5. And that is 5, 7, 8. Second section, C. C and B we're using here. Okay. Etc. So C major to B major. First run occurs on the offbeat of 2. Okay, so it's pushed. The run in question, the little kind of picked part. 3, 2, 3, open, and a hammer on back to the B there, and that leads me nicely back into the C. Don't catch that bass string. I'll try that again on the second half. Again, I'm going to go back to the C there. I sometimes just play the open, the root note. Just for effect, you could dive straight back into the chord. Second time. Watch that bass E string. So the only difference on the second time on your C and B part is that your run starts half a beat earlier. Half a beat earlier on beat 2, and it kicks off with the open D string. Okay. Back to that E7. As you've played. Right, and then there's only one more part to the song, the outro part, and it features that kazoo solo as well, which is really good. And I really like this part because it seems to be a really joyous, radical departure from the rest of the song. You know, you don't expect it. So the first time you're playing C, G with B in the bass. what you've got to do here is second fret fifth string, and then I'd use my little finger because just easier positional wise on the D, third fret second string. Again, two things I would try to do here is maybe try and mute the, you certainly want to mute the bass string with your finger. And again, I try and keep that fairly tidy by, if I can, just not hit. It's not a massive problem, but trying to keep the first string muted as well. D7. This is just a shape I'm in. This is that part. I'm playing D7 here because I'm trying to get the D at the top of the chord. Rather than if I played D7 here. It's just too much for me to have that. When you listen to the song, I don't think you hear the F sharp right at the top of the chord. So I'll play that shape there. And if you've never done that, that's 5, 4, 5, 3. Again, with this chord, I'm only trying to target the fifth, fourth, third, and second string. So I'm muting the bass string here. Muting is very important, and I think when people are learning guitar, they, or they're watching someone play, and they go, wow, you know, it's really good, sounds great. I'm not saying that about me, by the way, but I'm just saying what people don't see often is the other role that this hand does, that your fretting hand, and that's muting. Okay, so I'm it means I can just play really relaxed, all right? So I'm trying to mute the bass string, and again, I'm just going to be maybe a little bit lazy and just try and mute that. Okay, so one technique to maybe look at. Okay, G, D7, sorry, back to G. Standard G's here. Okay, so. Then we go E, A, C, D, G. And again on that one. Kazoo solo. Brings it to an end. Okay, so pretty standard shapes. At the very end there, I'm just going back just to that G5, just to give it a bit of, you know, something a bit different instead of stopping dead on the G, but you don't have to throw that in really. A lovely little acoustic track from a truly fabulous band, Blind Melon, R.I.P. Shannon Hoon. And hope you have fun with that one. Do check them out if you've never heard of them, or you know, you've heard bit the kind of, when I say the famous songs, they were a massive radio band, I guess, but No Rain certainly broke them, the debut single. But that first album, Blind Melon, and then Soup, the second album, which has got a different feel altogether. A bit darker, a bit more broodier. But honestly, I love that album. I love them both. Give them a whirl. Anyway, hope you have fun, hope you enjoyed the lesson, and I'll see you soon. Crack on.